Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. How you guys are doing today? Hope you guys are doing great. Today's video is especially for all of the art sellers via the Shopify store. So if you're selling wall art paintings via your Shopify store, then this video is for you. After watching this video, you'll be able to boost your sale by adding AR functionality to your store. So your visitors and your potential customers will be able to see how the art look on their offices, on their walls, on their houses. So it's a cool functionality which you can add to give them live experience of how that art is going to look like. Really cool video with a cool functionality. Make sure to watch the complete video if you want better understanding and if you want to add this functionality to your store. So the app which I'm gonna demo you guys today to add AR functionality is called Picture It Wall Art Previews. As you can see, and as I have told you guys, you can demo AR previews and it can basically show up on your walls, on your offices, and it has a lot of cool functionalities. First, I'm gonna show you guys in the demo store which they have. So if you go to this app, by the way, link of this app will be in the description. And by opening that link, you will have this view demo store where you can see how this app will add the functionality on your store. So as you can see, we have this painting, and if I click on view in room, we have this painting on our wall. These are pre-added walls, and you can also change the placement here, right? And you can also your own house wall by clicking on upload button here. And you can, after creating the preview, you can then click on save to download to make sure that how it's going to look. And this is also a really cool functionality, which is view in AR. So it's going to preview through your phone. I'm gonna add the preview that how it's going to look in your phone. Okay guys, I hope you guys have seen the preview on mobile, that how it's going to work. Now here we have some more settings here for changing the angle. So let's suppose I want to display this painting on top of the other painting which we have here. I'm just gonna drag and drop here and then change the angle to understand that how it's going to look, right? And here we have different units, feet and meters. So if you have the wall, if you have the measurement in meters or feet, you can adjust the settings and adjust the space of your wall, right? And adjust the sizing of the painting. Cool. Now in this video, I'm going to demo you guys how you can add the product and how you can add this functionality via this app. And this is my development store where I've already added this functionality on my store. So if I click on that, you can see I have this painting, which I can see in the preview right now. These are the instructions which you will find in the app, where it's going to basically tell you how you can add the product and dimensions and then enable this app functionality. So let's start by doing that. I'm going to open up the backend of my development store. Here I have this app installed already. So click on that app. And here's how the dashboard of our app looks like. And if we go click on this, go to my products, you can see these products where I have already activated this functionality of live preview, right? So now first we will add a new product so I can show you guys how you can add the product and then basically configure it. So let's click on products. And all of these instructions are available here. So you can simply add it here and add the dimensions. Right now, let's start by doing that. So first we'll be adding the product and add our dimensions, just like which we have here in the screenshot, right? So let's add the product. I'm going to click on add product and then name my painting as new painting, just to demo you guys how it's going to work. I'm going to click on media, and I've already added some painting pictures. So I'm going to select this one, for example. And now let's set the price. I'm gonna add the dummy price. And now let's add the variations. I'm going to click on add options like size or color, where we will be adding size. And here we will have small, medium, and large. And we will also be adding the dimensions, just like we have it mentioned here. So here you can see we have small 12 by 16, 16 by 22, and 20 by 28. So let's add that. 12 inches by 16. What was that? Yeah. 16 inches. 16 inches by 22 inches. And for the large one, we have 20. For the large one, we have 20 by 28. 20 inches by 28 inches. Perfect. Now let's click on done and hit save. After saving, we will also select the variant images. So let's add in the variant image. I'm going to select the same image for now. Perfect. Let's hit save. Awesome. Our product is now added on our store. Now, as per the instruction, if you scroll down, we will go to our app and click on my products and then activate our product. How we can do that? So let's go to our app. Here's our app called Picture It. And from this app, I'm going to click on go to my products. And from here, I'm going to activate that on the new painting which we added. So this is the one. Let's click on activate. And then it's asking you to remove the background. So as you can see, this painting has this beige color background, which is going to disturb our live preview. So we should have it as PNG removed background. And it's going to automatically do that for all of the variants and for the main product image. So let's click on activate for all variants and then click on confirm. And here you can see that it's giving us the option to remove the background. So I'm going to click on remove background and it's going to automatically remove the background from my painting. There you go. Now you can see that there is no background showing up. It's just the painting which is showing up. You can do the same for the variant image. So if I click on variant and then click on remove background, click confirm. Similarly, do that for the other variants. Perfect. Background for all of the variants has been removed. And here we have the option to change the unit as well. So if you have dimension on any other unit, you can select that. Inches, centimeter, right? It's basically dependent on you. Okay, background, we will use background collection one. So what is the background collection? So if I go to my product where I've already added that, and if I click on live preview, that's what the background collection is, right? So you can select the background collection here, and you can also create your own background collection. So if I scroll down here we have option to create our own background collection, which I'm going to tell you how you can create your own background collection. Right now, after setting this up, click on save. And now let's preview it on our product. Now I'm going to go back to my store, close this one here, and then click on all products. And here we will find for the product which we created. So that's the one. It's currently showing up sold out, so we will also add some inventory. First, let's see how the live preview feature looks like. Okay, so here's the live preview button showing up. Click on that. and here's our painting showing up. We can change, show full background, angle, label. So all of these settings can be adjusted, right? And if you had multiple variants, you could also choose from the variants and display that on the live preview as well. Let me take a look if that painting on the demo store have different variants so we can set up different images for variant and show you how it's gonna work. Okay, here we have size. Nope. Okay, for this painting, I think we have different frame colors. Yep. So I'm gonna take picture from that and show you guys how we can do that on displaying different variant. Do we have the, yeah, we can display it on our demo store. So if I change the variant to black frame, right, and click on view room, it's going to show you the same variant here for the preview. And again, if you want to view that on your mobile version, simply click on the view in AR and then scan this QR code and you will be able to preview this painting on any of your wall wherever you take your mobile camera, right? Now let's check it out with the wood version, view in room. And here we have the same variant image for the preview. Cool. You can also upload your own wall of office or home, as I have already told you guys, right? Now let's show you guys the collection thing. So if I click on virtual showrooms, all of the backgrounds are showing up from here. So that's the first collection which I have created. And here we have these different walls. You can create multiple collections from here. So simply click on virtual showrooms and then click on create collection to create a collection. Now let's go over some settings here. Here we have the option to customize the button. So if you want to change the position of the button, if you want to change the size of the button, if you want the small, mega, or we can also animate that. So here you can see we have this animation showing up, right? We can enable or disable the rounded corners. We can add the drop shadow. Now here it has the drop shadow. We can enable, disable the preview image, or if you want to add your own custom CSS, you can add it on here. So here we have the option to add in custom CSS as well. Here we have the option of selecting the language. Currently it supports German, French, Spanish, Arabic. And this is for the branding. If you want to display the picture it branding, you can, or if you want to hide it, you can simply toggle this on. So these are the settings of the app, and that's it for the video, guys. That's it for the functionality of this app, a really cool app which you can add on your store to add an AR functionality and increase your sales if you're selling the wall art or painting. And if you have any questions, they have really good support. So you can simply go to the app page. Here they have a support mention. Here's the support button. So click on get support. You can also do that within the app. So click on help here and let's discard this and then click on help. You can contact the support. They also have this chart button showing up on the app. So simply click on that and you can share your own queries, and they are going to get back to you really soon. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys like it. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions or confusions. Until next video, have a great day.